In this video, we discuss transformers. These are a critical part of electrical distribution systems, but they are also found in audio devices like DIs and splitters. First, we'll see how transformers use electromagnetic induction. Then we talk about how transformers step up or step down voltage. And finally, we discussed how direct current cannot pass through a transformer. One of the main ways we utilize electromagnetic induction is with a transformer. Now, in its simplest form, a transformer has two copper coils. Now, if we run an alternating current through one of the coils, we'd also create a corresponding magnetic field. And since the second coil is in that magnetic field, a corresponding alternating current will be induced into that coil. Now, in a perfect world, if the two coils had exactly the same number of windings, the transfer from one coil to the other would be 1-to-1. The current and voltage on one coil would induce the exact same current and voltage in the other coil. But of course, this doesn't always exactly work perfectly because copper conductors do have a small amount of resistance, and we know that that does change things, but it is pretty close. However, if one of the coils has twice as many windings, there won't be an equal transfer of voltage. It will actually be proportional to the ratio of the windings, which in this case is 2-to-1. So if we put 240 volts on the first coil, it would induce 120 volts in the coil with half the windings. And this works in both directions, which is how we step up or step down voltage. And even though it's not really about show power, I do just want to point out that this is the same method a passive DI uses to knock a line level audio signal down to mic level. Because after all, an audio signal is alternating current. Now, there are transformers all throughout the power grid that step up and step down power. And this is critical in getting efficient long-range transmission. But once it hits our power distros, it's going to be at the voltage of whatever country we're in, either 120 or 240, and that's what we use to power the show. But if we have gear that's made to run on the other voltage, which does happen a lot when we get into international touring, we do need a small power transformer on stage. Now, these can even be pretty small and portable if we don't need too much current, but if we're running like a tube bass amp, like that one behind me that runs on 120 volts, if I wanted to use that on stage in Europe, I would need a fairly substantial transformer to step down from 240. Now, at some of the more pro festivals where they really know what they're doing, they do provide both 240 and 120 volts on stage to easily accommodate international tours. Or venues that often host international artists might have some small transformers to take care of some musical gear on stage. And increasingly, many devices are just capable of handling both 120 and 240 volts. So, the whole function of a transformer is based on electromagnetic induction, which relies on a fluctuating magnetic field. But if we have a static magnetic field, like the one produced by direct current, there won't be any current induced by the transformer. Now, this essentially means that the transformer will not pass any direct current. Now, one reason we care about this in audio is because we sometimes use transformer-isolated splitters. These split audio signals to the front of house and monitor consoles using transformers, which actually keeps the consoles electronically separated, which is good. But it also means that whatever console is connected to the transformer side cannot supply the 48 volts of direct current that we call phantom power. In this video, we saw how transformers use electromagnetic induction, how they can step up or step down voltages, and how they cannot pass direct current.